invite you to face the reader. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In the water of baptism, Loretta died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery your servant Loretta, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
And summoned from its far-off places, you whom I have called my servant, whom I have chosen and will not cast off. Fear not, I am with you. Be not dismayed, I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you and uphold you with my right hand of justice. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Lord is my light and my salvation. Of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid? The Lord is my light and my salvation. Of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid? The Lord is my light and my help. Whom should I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Before whom should I shrink? The Lord is my light and my salvation. Of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid? There is one thing I ask of the Lord, for this I long, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid? I believe I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Hope in God and take heart. Hope in the Lord. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid?
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy, chapter 4, verses 6 through 8, 17 through 18. I, Paul, am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day. And not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The Lord stood by me and gave me strength, so that through me the proclamation might be completed, and that all the Gentiles might hear it. And I was rescued from the lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from every evil threat and will bring me safe to his heavenly kingdom. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Oh, dear family and friends, on behalf of Father Zach, our pastor, and myself, and all of us here at St. Teresa, please be assured of our continued prayers and support for you throughout these coming days. Reading about Loretta's life, I was somewhat struck, in a good way, by how she was described. Of the many ways that we may describe someone or sum up their life, Loretta was described as being a devoted Catholic who had a great devotion to the Blessed Virgin Mary. I did not have the pleasure of knowing Loretta personally. However, reading that little bit about her tells me that she was a woman of great love and great faith. And what better remembrance could there be than to be remembered as a follower of Jesus? I was reminded of one of my favorite quotes from St. Thérèse of Lisieux, who once said, "The loveliest masterpiece of the heart of God is the heart of a mother." As a devotee of Our Lady, Loretta's maternal heart was shaped and guarded by the Mother of God, the most perfect and shining example of maternal love that has ever been created by the hand of God. I have no doubt that as a mother and a friend, Loretta taught you many things throughout her life, the greatest of which is to allow yourself to experience the maternal care and embrace of Mary, the mother of all creation. The saints of the church remind us time and time again that the quickest, most direct way to our Lord is through the hands of his blessed mother. In turning to her, we behold the face of Christ, for her gaze is always fixed on her Son, our Lord Jesus. It is a beautiful and fitting thing that today we gather here to commend our sister to the Lord, as so much of her life points us back to this very place. Loretta was baptized here. She went to school here. And today she comes back to the very place where she first received the light of Christ and the gift of faith that she nurtured and guarded throughout her life. On that day, entering into the waters of baptism, Loretta was cleansed of all stain of sin, marked for Christ Jesus, and endowed with the Spirit of the living God. Today, the light of faith that was given to her at her baptism is made present to us through sign and symbol in the Easter candle. This candle, blessed at the Easter vigil, stands as a reminder for us of the light of Christ, which burns brightly in our lives, never to be overcome by the darkness of suffering and difficulty. For you who now remain, the race of faith that she, together with Saint Paul and all the saints, so faithfully ran is now yours to run. Guided by the light of Christ and aided by Mary's maternal care, it is now for you to pursue the crown of righteousness that is only to be found in the kingdom of heaven. As you mourn the loss of your mother and friend, follow the example that has been given to you by her. Allowing the light of faith to guard you along the way, you will then be able to echo those words of St. Paul. The Lord stood by me, and he gave me strength. As we prepare to commend our sister to the loving embrace of the Father, I leave you with these words from St. Francis de Sales, who directs us to the presence of God in our lives. He says, "The same everlasting Father who comes for you today will take care of you tomorrow and every day. Be at peace, then. Put aside all anxious thoughts and imaginations, and say continually, 'The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart has trusted in him, and I am helped. He is not only with me, but in me, and I in him.'" Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Please stand. With great confidence and trust in the love and mercy of our Heavenly Father, we bring to him our needs and petitions.
With love, we lift up Loretta, a woman of deep faith who exemplified the model of a devoted mother and grandmother. Now that she has been freed from all her limitations, may she now rest and rejoice in the presence of God's eternal love and glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With compassion, we pray for Loretta's children and their spouses. May they find solace knowing that the cross of suffering that Loretta bore has now brought her to the resurrection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With concern, we lift up all those who are sick or dying or have lost a loved one. May their pain bring God's comfort, their discouragement bring his strength, and their loneliness bring his friendship. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the deceased members of the Schlosser, Niehaus, and Wilson families. Even as we remember them in death, we express our gratitude for their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Loretta, that we may be gathered again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of mercy and author of life, we give you thanks and praise for the gift of life that was given to Loretta. We ask now that she be received into your loving embrace through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for the preparation of the altar.
Number 728, eye has not seen, number 728.
Of God.
lives are but a single breath. We flower and we fade, yet all our days are in your hands. So we return in love what love has made. Eye has not seen, ear has not heard what God has ready for those who love him. Spirit of love, come give us the mind of Jesus. Teach us the wisdom of God. To those who see with eyes of faith, the Lord is ever near, reflected in the faces of all the poor and lowly of the world. Eye has not seen, ear has not heard what God has ready for those who love him. Spirit of love, come give us the mind of Jesus. Teach us the wisdom of God.
Please stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours would be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Loretta, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. By the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church in recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Teresa and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Dennis, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Loretta, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Ask that you cross your arms over your chest, and the minister will give to you a prayer of blessing. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I have loved you. Number 588.
Of the Lord and long for him.
will bring you his joy and his hope. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. Seek the face of the Lord and long for him. He will bring you his care and his love. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine.
Sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Loretta may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Please be seated for words of remembrance.
I ask for your patience this morning because if there's one thing my mother and I had in common, it was the tendency to cry at a commercial. So you can only imagine what might happen at a funeral. Thank you for all being here today. It means so much to know that Mom meant so much to each of you. And thank you for honoring Mom by wearing purple. I know she would look out on all these tones and shades of her favorite color and think to herself, now that's a group I'd like to be a part of. Most of you have probably read Mom's obituary by now, and wow, was that not something I was looking forward to writing. In the end, though, I wish it was something I had written earlier and even shared with her. Why not let someone you know you've been paying attention and take the time to celebrate with them everything that makes them who they are. I missed that opportunity. Of course, since publishing the obituary, I realized I also missed a few key points that I thought I would share today. Flea markets. How did I forget about flea markets? One of my strongest early memories of Mom, every Sunday morning, over at the Den Drive-In, where the Walmart is now, every once in a while, one of us was able to will ourselves awake early enough to brave the dawn and shop with her for jelly bracelets or matchbox cars or toy figurines. Over and back all before Sunday morning mass. Brats. She loved brats. Summer brats, and apparently no one makes them better than the church festivals. She would hit them all summer long, just for the brats and only for the brats. I have no idea how she managed parking, getting to the booth, getting back to her car. You can never park close. But that was her. She set her mind to something, she was determined to make it happen, and she found the wherewithal to follow through. Her signature doubled up reading glasses. Why wear one pair of glasses when you can wear two? And why conform when you can just be yourself? Mom was always unabashedly, uniquely herself. Bengals. She didn't really love the Bengals so much as she loved when they were winning. She would have loved last night. She wouldn't watch the games, but she would call me and ask me nervously, "Did they win? Did they win?" I didn't hear any fireworks. She felt the mood shift in the community was palpable, and because she worked with the public, she knew people were genuinely happier and kinder to one another with the excitement of a winning team. This one's gonna get me. Her favorite song. She had a few favorites, actually. Practically anything by Andy Williams, a few from Cher. But if you were to ask anyone who's known her long enough, the song, "I Hope You Dance," performed by Leanne Womack, is always the first answer. It's the song of a mother expressing her wish that her children will step out, embrace life, and take a chance on love and faith. It goes a little something like this. I'm not gonna sing. I hope you never lose your sense of wonder. You get your fill to eat, but always keep that hunger. May you never take one single breath for granted. God forbid love ever leave you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you will give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you never fear those mountains in the distance. Never settle for the path of least resistance. Living might mean taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some hell-bent heart leave you bitter. When you come close to selling out, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing glance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. As we leave here today, let's reflect on the gifts Mom left us with simply by living her life as her true self. Find the thing that inspires you to get up at dawn on a Sunday. Take life's obstacles and tell them, "Not me, not today." Be yourself, leave your mark, and embrace others that do the same. The world will be richer for it. Find life's joy and share it, even when your team is losing. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, just dance. And lastly, I would suggest wear purple for someone you love just because you do. Mom, thank you for loving us and inspiring us through it all. I hope you're dancing.
Thank you.
Please stand. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. For one day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. We commend our sister Loretta in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Loretta in this life, for they are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the sure and certain hope of the resurrection, we take leave of our sister and let us go now in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Number 691, On Eagle's Wings, number 691.
Like the sun.